So the reason I'm posting this right now is because there's a peak in crime in your area. We're actually putting these blue deterrent signs. They're crime deterrent signs in your front yard. And we are qualifying customers to get their own surveillance systems. Now, there's kids in your area that are stealing mail. They're vandalizing. Property damage has increased in your area. And this sometimes can even lead to assault. It's crazy. Now, I'm sure you've thought about getting a camera, right? So these kids are stealing, they're vandalizing, they're stealing people's mail. Property damage has increased. And also, there's assault cases. It's crazy. Okay, I've had some experience myself. Now, here's one thing. There's a problem here. A lot of times, these kids are not getting caught because you either don't have a camera at all, any type of surveillance camera, or you do have a camera, but it's just inefficient. So we're here basically to provide you some of the best quality cameras on the market that will help you lower crime for your neighbors as well as yourself. And we do qualify you, and we do pay for four things. We're gonna pay for about $600 worth of equipment. We're paying for that equipment for you. Second of all, we're going to pay for the installation. You don't have to worry about installation. It's like $199, we're gonna pay for that. So you don't have to pay for that. We're also gonna have what's known as an independent network. Let's just say that your Wi-Fi gets cut off. We're gonna keep our own personal Wi-Fi on for you. And that is actually $99, which we're paying for. So you don't have to worry about that today. As long as you keep the equipment on, then you're good to go for as long as you stay with us. It's $54.99 per month. And we get started just like how you would with Netflix or anything. Just routing number and account number. All right, July 14th, 2023. We're dealing with 183,000 miles, 170 miles, 94 degrees Fahrenheit. And there's the second church known as Chick-fil-A. Sorry. Where did you get, you got the hat at Krispy Kreme? Okay. Did not know this, but when you apply for a leadership position at Chick-fil-A, you have to do a book review. And then they move forward after that. Pretty cool. This book right here, okay? How did you do it? Truett. And I read this book, and then I turn in a book review, and that's the next step to the leadership thing. So that's what he told me I do. It takes like 45 minutes to read this book, and then that's what he said. I don't know if it's big print or whatever. Yeah, it's big print. So it's like a children's book or something. I read this, I do a book review. Or it's like a young adult.
But then he determines if you get hired as a crew member or shift leader? What if you fail?
It's a leadership. It's a leadership.
What if you fail it?
No, it has questions in it.
Well, what if you fail it?
Sweetie.
Could you at least be a crew member?
I have a postgraduate degree, okay? I'm a graduate from college.
Okay, that's
okay, we did review on Dostoevsky. Dostoevsky. We did reviews on Dostoevsky. All she knows is David Mamet talking over me. Okay.
Sorry.
And Lanford Wilson.
Welcome.
All right, got it. Okay. So basically, I read this and I do a book review. Okay? And then that's how they do the leadership position. It has questions in it. There's a whole thing that it leads you through.
I want my Barbie on the shrimp. I'm not gonna say awesome blossom. It's
Australia is kind of like this.
Don't forget that dark rye bread they have.
Put all the shrimp on the Barbie. It's almost like New Zealand, where they talk like this on where the beach is, kind of. because they're all criminals from the UK, and they put them on an island in Australia, and it's a little more, it's a little more accent-y and southern than how we talk, a little bit. It's almost Cockney at the time. Think of Mel Gibson, right? That's the Australia.
Illegal.
Well, I can't tell her not. And you know what? Let's pull him over. That's a joke. Pull over. Pull over.
Score. That's a good take-home a food right there.
You don't get free food over there, do
you? Oh, they throw it away anyway.
Yeah, does it look like I'm even friends with the kitchen people that are Mexicans? No.
Okay, let's not get too
political. Well, I'm just saying.
It is true, but let's not get too political. Well,
I did yell at them at the
other. Yeah, I know you have to say those kinds of things, but that's fine.
Or the white people. Or the black people. Or the Asians. I'm not friends with the kitchen. Back of house people. You think they talk to me? You think they want to be my friend? You think they want to hang out with me? No. Nobody wants to be my friend. 40-something years, I'm still. Mom, happy birthday. I still don't have any friends, thank you.
I'm your friend.
Oh, shut up, you don't care.
Dustin's your friend.
Oh, shut up, you don't care.
You like, what's her name? Joanna? Joanna?
She's not my friend, she doesn't hang out with me. Who plays board games with me?
I do. I played Millionaire.
We need to do that tonight.
Who wants to be a millionaire? Remember? We played that together. Hey, we need to play that again. Let's play that tonight. Who wants to be a millionaire? Okay. We're going to play Who Wants to Be a Millionaire tonight. We've got the board game. I still have it.
Yes, I know.
Mm-hmm. And I got another board game, too. Oh, you know what we could play? We could play Jenga.
Maybe tomorrow.
Mr. S. Truett, founder and chairman, Chick-fil-A, Incorporated, 5200... Buffington Road, Atlanta, Georgia, 30349-2998. Dear Truett, I enjoyed both your letter and the annual report. I particularly liked your comments about being 85 with a lot of good years ahead. You and I have the same philosophy toward life. With the fun you are having with your business, you are 100% right and not selling it. How could the world be any better? Your offer of Chick-fil-A sandwich is powerful, particularly with the added salt thrown in. Keep a seat reserved for me at your lunch table. Truett, I really admire what you have accomplished. And with you at the helm, the best is yet to come. Best regards, sincerely, Warren E. Buffett. Copyrighted 2007. Literary LLC. Manufactured in Canada. Have you ever eaten a spoonful of lard? What about a cup of sifted flour or a cup of sugar? Or maybe a couple of raw eggs? Probably not, but everybody has enjoyed a delicious cake. The result of mixing those ingredients together in the right proportion and baking them.
When I was a boy, on a rainy Sunday afternoon, I would go into my mother's kitchen to bake a cake, and I learned the importance of having all the right ingredients. If I didn't have a necessary ingredient to complete the cake, I might try a substitute. Sometimes it worked, and sometimes I made a flop. Building a business is like that. It takes all the right ingredients, something I would say a lot, the ingredients. I'd always say ingredients. Everybody in all places of responsibility doing their jobs. Some people think good concept is most important or a good product. Others think it's a location or the team or the marketing plan. They're all right. It's all of these things and more. Oftentimes, when we experience success at Chick-fil-A, I pat myself on the back and congratulate myself for the accomplishment. Then, I have to remind myself, Truett, you didn't do it. God did it, along with the high-quality people at Chick-fil-A, who have great ideas and work extremely hard to make the business successful, and our loyal fans who are just as important to our success. When I began working on this book, I asked those working in Chick-fil-A restaurants and our corporate headquarters about the ingredients to our success, and some of their comments are presented in boxes labeled, How Truett Did It, in a sidebar statement. Number one, success begins when you really want to. I read the book as fast as I could, but I was only halfway down the page when the boy beside me turned to the next page. It was the 1930s, and we shared school books because there wasn't enough money for all the students to have their own. My teacher paired me with a student, with an A student, and no matter how fast I read, he always turned the page before I was ready. And every time the page turned, my self-concept fell a notch. 75 years later, I remember my difficult school days when I speak to a graduating class. How many of you are straight A students? I ask. A group of hands goes up and I say, well, too bad for you. I understand the world is run by C students. And that's true. When you read the history, when you read the history books about outstanding individuals, you see that many of them didn't have brilliant minds. Instead, they had common sense and worked hard to accomplish their goals. I'm sure a lot of them were like me when they were young, slow readers and slow learners. And I didn't have much confidence in my ability. When I was young, I learned the harder you work, the more successful you will be. That holds true today. My parents didn't have a lot of money, so I knew that if I wanted nice things, and I did, the only way to get those things was to work hard and save my money. I explained a simple formula for success whenever somebody asked me, how'd you do it, Truett? In those difficult days of the Great Depression, financial success meant just making a living. And if you had a regular income, you were considered a wealthy person. So when I thought about how I might make my living as an adult, I considered the possibilities that would allow me to earn enough money to take care of the family I hope to have someday. Ultimately, I decided to open a restaurant, but it could just as easily have been a service station or a grocery store. I like the idea of building something and owning it. A lot of people thought like that in the 1940s. Tom Brokaw called ours the greatest generation. And he said to us, there came an age during the Great Depression, the Second World War, went on to build a modern America. Men and women whose everyday lives of duty, honor, achievement, and courage gave us the world we have today. The NBC News anchor interviewed dozens of people to write The Greatest Generation.
And most of them told him something along the lines of, I just did what I had to do. We didn't dream big dreams. We didn't set out to become heroes or to create great economic expansion. The world has ever seen, we simply took care of our families and ourselves, built with quality, and tried to look out for our neighbors. Hard work and opportunities. Through the years, I've had hundreds of people ask me how I could start from where I did and build a company with sales nearly $3 billion. So throughout the years of 1970 through the 1990s, America stopped eating beef. They went down 15% on intake of beef. So it dropped 15%. And poultry went nuts. Everyone was eating poultry. Now this happened, and his store, which was Truett's store, it just went nuts. So he went from 6 restaurants to 958 restaurants almost overnight, nearly. There were the same years that the Chick-fil-A experienced a tremendous growth from 6 restaurants, they just had 6 of them, to 958. That's an amazing increase right there, just because people stopped eating beef and they started eating chicken, which they still eat a lot of chicken today. You can go into Walmart, look at Starkist. Starkist Tuna actually does chicken now. You can get Starkist chicken. So they don't just do tuna. So chicken is still increasing, meaning people are eating more and more chicken. It's amazing. So that's what made him right there. People started eating chicken, and he hit that bubble in the market and created one of the biggest chicken places, even bigger than McDonald's when it comes to chicken. Let me put it this way, because of Truett, it proved to America that chicken is a craze. If you're a chicken, you better be real good at being a pet. Explain something about chickens. My mother has a sanctuary of chickens. That means she keeps them alive, because my mom is a humanitarian that loves life. I never would have made it to the theatrical stage because I'm an actor, but I do this type of work too. My mother keeps these chickens very safe. She has names for the chickens, and she loves the chickens very much. They're her pets. They're like family members. And the reason why is because the chicken and the rooster, especially the chicken, is the most sought after animal or beast or fowl on the planet, especially America. If you're a chicken, there's a real good chance that you're gonna die, unless you find a sanctuary, which my mom runs. My mom has several chickens that she keeps safe, protected, and well alive, far from the Thanksgiving table. And most of the time, on the Thanksgiving table, it's turkey, but they do eat chicken Thanksgiving too. So $4 billion is nothing to scoff at. But look, you've got yourself one piece of chicken right here and 2 pickles. That's it. That's his genius. Breaded chicken, 2 pickles. And of course, you know, the bread on the outside to make the sandwich. That was his special ingredient. All right, so following Linda around is kind of like a jigsaw. Okay. So she was saying something.
Maybe she was on the headphone or something. Mm-hmm. And then, she did look like she's probably in her 50s or something.
So Linda knows a really nice lady at Subway. And she's gonna.
Sorry.
She's gonna go talk to her. I'm parked right over this way.
Yeah.
It's over this way. Over here. Over here? Okay. Do you want me to park over here? I'll just come around this way and park over here. You want to park over next to on the parking lot? Huh?
Become homeless?
It's probably for, no, there's a donation center right next door. About like about 100 yards that way, donation center. It's for donating clothes. They just missed the drop by about 100 yards.
Yeah, so their Dr. Peppers are $1. That's actually a good deal. That's a good deal. $1 for Dr. Pepper. Oh, good thing that bus is there. You gotta have a vending license, but I mean, what are they gonna do? Ticket? You just don't pay the ticket. Oh, it disappeared. That was quick. 1 minute was there, 1 minute wasn't. They got headphones on. This is where I took Jennifer Quarles to go see the piano. She was the woman that D-I-C-K'd me over. D-I-C-K-E-D? She D-I-C-K-E-D'd me over. Anyway, this is the AMC I went to see the piano with Harvey Keitel and Holly Hunter. We didn't go all together, but that would have been cool. It was directed by Jane Campion.
Gotcha.
At the bottom there's career. You can do Q110 if you like.
Gotcha. I see the QR outside. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yep, you're welcome. All right. So it's somewhere out here. There it is. It's right here. He looks happy, doesn't he? The QR scanner. Okay.
I'm gonna use that, and I'll wait for you right over there.
Okay. Linda's idea. You said to get the what? The birds?
It's like Kill a Mockingbird.
It is like Kill a Mockingbird. You're a little Harper Lee.
And get yourself a typewriter.
Harper Lee wrote To Kill a Mockingbird. And just had a Watchmen.
Paper applications? Yeah. That's cool. They have paper applications.
And that girl had about 50 tattoos.
Ooh, they have now hiring sign?
Hello? 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 Did you apply? How'd it go? Did it work out?
Yeah.
Linda, being so wise, throws her phone in another white Kia that looks exactly like mine. White Kia looks like mine.
And the dog.
She throws the phone in a white Kia that looks like mine. Got the sentence out.
The dog let me on the left side of the face. Then I left my phone over there. We had to go back. Mm-hmm. Why is a dog over there in the state of Texas in a car? I don't give a shit if the freaking crap.
Watch the language.
AC.
Right, we're cutting here.
Coming out of the freaking little tanning salon. And a little precious dog was in the back seat. So I
right,
got in the
because
car.
The car is white, like, hey, looks Cole, like mine, looks like a similar car. It looks like my car. So she throws her phone in someone else's car. It's exactly white Forte that looks exactly like mine.
Let's go back.
No, we're not going back. It's one of the most common cars around.
I want to see if the dog's still in the car.
I'll show you
car.
What my business card looks like later. Looks like a drive.
She's
symbol.
Probably getting her nails done. No, do it now.
Do what?
I want to see if the dog's still in the car.
I'm just dropping this off over here. Linda is going to explain what happened.
I got in a white Kia.
Was it mine?
No, it wasn't yours.
But you thought it was mine.
Yes, I thought it was yours. And then I saw a dog. It went like that.
And where was your phone?
Because I left it on the side of the door.
No, you left it right there on the
seat. It reminds me of the dog that Melissa Beth Owens
has. You jumped out and left the phone in a foreign car.
Yes, it's a foreign car.
Right.
I want to see if the dog's still in there. Because it's not going to be right. The dog's still in there.
I think she's getting her nails done because she has money.
It's like 103 degrees outside.
Oh! I think it's funny. I need to tell you right now.
What's your cigarette? Put your arm through my arm like that so I can lead you in.
Hey, Carabelle, I thought I'd send you a message.
All right, here we go. Ooh, they got to create your own combo right here. It's only $12.89 for two. Choose three for $3.98. I don't know if it's a single though, or if it's double. It says create a combo. You get one soft taco, beef, chicken, crispy, and a pork tamale. Cheese enchilada, beef enchilada, a chicken chalupe, beef chalupe or bean, and queso chalupe or guacamole. It's a pretty good one. Appreciate it. Show you a little trick right here I learned from a Latino mom. What you do, you take a little bit of butter, which they don't have any butter, you can see on the table. You mix the butter with the sugar. Oh, they do have that butter there. You take the butter, you push it out like this. Then you take the sugar and you put the sugar on the butter. Take a little bit of salsa, not a whole lot, just a little bit. You got yourself a nice little sugar tortilla. A little piece of candy. Mmm. That's good.
Spanish, but not a lot. But it's not really. And I also worked at Holiday Inn too, but short period. So I broke up with the boys, you know, so. A little bit of hotel experience up over there. I mean, I just don't know what you're looking for, or front desk, or, you know, housekeeper. Well, that's good. Because I'm an open, honest person, because I used to work at, I mean, I signed bagels at Sonic as being a manager. And I don't like to, like, you know, jig people around. So I'll be like, oh, you're hiring or you're not hiring, you know. I already went to, like, five places today. Nope, not hiring. It's like, well, I already got slapped in the face five times today. That's why I'm going to get some chips and salsa out of here next week. That's more for me. So it's like Linda, but it's Brenda. That's really awesome. So Brenda, cool. Okay, well, I'll let
90s,
you...
probably like, I'd say like early 90s, 1990, 91, 92, 93, 94. This was a Mervyn's, a California Mervyn's. It was a place where you can get clothing and shoes and things like that. So what? Who cares? It says it's on patrol. Who cares? All kinds of cops. Crop cops are criminals too. Did you know that? Hoytzclaw got 266 years in life in prison. That's 266 years. They rarely ever do that to a criminal.
and he called himself a cop. Doesn't mean anything.
Oh,
that badge doesn't mean anything.
Song?
Hey, put your thing on right there. I am taking you home.
They're all the way from Missouri.
I decided to go into McDonald's. I'm going to QR McDonald's and see what it's like to fill out an application at McDonald's. Because a lot of them where you just QR. Here's the McDonald's right there. So we're going to go in and just QR them and see what's going on. They got a 100% tuitions covered right here. So if you go to school, 100% tuition. I've gone to school in postgrad. Apparently, you just drop off a resume, so it's very rare for McDonald's, but yeah, they ask for a resume. So I drop off a resume. This is a really nice place, and I think they can be a really good place for you. They're really nice to people. You just go in there, smile, just be confident with your head up.
I'm gonna be smiling. My Sonic only gave me one day next week. Screw them.
They got like putt green grass over there. I'll show you the putt green grass. It's like you could putt on this grass right over here. Look how nice it is. This grass right here, it's all like just like you putt like a golfing. Here to do golfing.
I have a future job.
That's how you do it. You just be nice to people. And then next thing you know. Anyway, the grass is really nice.
Okay, now give it a shot. You got it. Just go in there with a big smile on your face, just like you are. You got good energy. You got lots of commercial music in there. You look great. Got it.
What's the thing that you have? What do you have?